Tonight we are going to retell a true story which changed the whole world, the birth of Jesus. The story starts not under a Christmas tree or in a sleigh with reindeers. The story begins with an angel, a messenger from God. His name was Gabriel. God had told him to find a young woman called Mary who lived in the town of Nazareth. Now, Gabriel didn't need to use sat-nav. He knew exactly where he would find Mary, kneeling by her bed saying her prayers. Mary's eyes were shut tight, but suddenly it didn't seem dark anymore. She blinked and looked. The angel Gabriel, dressed in white, was standing in the corner. Mary gasped.
Don't be afraid. God has chosen you to be the mummy of God's baby Jesus.
Mary gasped again.
But I haven't married Joseph yet.
Don't worry, your baby is God's special baby.
Mary thought about what Gabriel was saying. She thought so deeply that many minutes passed. Finally, she looked up into Gabriel's kind face. His eyes blazed like diamonds.
I will do whatever my heavenly father wants.
When Joseph heard that Mary was pregnant, he shook with shock.
Mary's going to have a baby and I'm not the dad.
In bed that night, Joseph tossed and turned. He was confused and didn't know what to do. Eventually, he fell sound asleep and the angel spoke to him in his dream. Suddenly, he woke up. He had an answer.
I'll treat Mary and a special baby. I'll treat him as my own.
Hear ye, hear ye, cried the town crier. The emperor has said that everyone's names must be put on a very big list. Everyone is to register it in their hometowns. When Joseph heard this, he thought, bad news.
Poor me, my hometown Bethlehem is such a long way away.
But when he discovered that Mary, who was very pregnant by this time, would have to come too, he sat down and cried.
God, why did it have to be like this?
Joseph loved Mary so much. They had little choice but to set off on a 70-mile journey on foot. It took them many days and their feet ached. Mary thought things couldn't get any worse, but they did. When they arrived in Bethlehem, the town was full of people, too busy to notice them. Suddenly, Mary felt her baby jump in her womb. She knew they must find shelter quickly, but where? Joseph tried all the lodging houses, but nobody could help. Then he saw the light of an inn down a dingy back alley. Maybe there would be a small room there, but the man who answered Joseph's knock shook his head. Joseph thought all was lost and whispered to Mary,
"Get right there."
All Mary could do was pray.
Please, God, help us.
Suddenly, the man at the inn called out, "If you don't mind the animals, I suppose you could kip down with them." When Mary saw the animal stalls, she was too tired to worry. Joseph fetched a light and made a cradle from the feeding trough. Looked rather cosy, but it was just as well because very soon Mary's baby was born. Mary placed Jesus in a cradle, and it was as if all the darkness had gone and everywhere looked warm and cosy. Even the animal sounds were comforting. And the angel Gabriel passed the good news on. On the hills outside Bethlehem, shepherds had been watching their sheep. Hungry wolves hid in the shadows, and sheep made them a tasty supper. It was cold and demanding work, and nobody wanted to do it. The village folk called them names and avoided the shepherds because they often smelt. Suddenly, the sky grew light, and Gabriel appeared. The light was so bright that the shepherds had to hide their eyes. They were so scared, but then they heard a voice saying,
"Tonight in Bethlehem, God's son has been born. He will be a great king. Glory to God in heaven. Peace on earth to everyone."
The shepherds blinked and rubbed their eyes. It was such a wonderful sight. The whole sky had come alive and the stars shone like diamonds. It was a heavenly fireworks display. And then, everywhere fell silent and calm. Later, much later, Mary and Joseph received another surprise. It started when they heard a strange noise outside. Joseph peeped out and said,
"Mary, I can see camels and men dressed in beautiful clothes. They look like kings."
Mary tried to do a quick tidy up, but it was too late. Before Joseph and Mary could say anything at all, their wealthy visitors were kneeling down in front of Jesus and offering him gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh. It was such a happy celebration. What wonderful gifts to bring. And ever since Jesus' birth, folk like you and I have been telling others the wonderful news that God's son Jesus was born to be our light in the darkness of this world. Good news.